farming represents over 50% of inhabitable land area on planet Earth. Having nature back into the heart of that food production will be transformative in so many ways. We'll have clean waterways, we'll have carbon locked up in the soil, and we'll have healthy people working on the land as well as those who eat the food. A regenerative system which produces food in harmony with nature, but also delivers for animal welfare, our own health, societal benefits. And that's really where the opportunity we have is. It's one of the few industries which at the moment is part of the problem, but has the opportunity to totally turn itself around and become part of the climate, nature and health solution. What's preventing us from moving from the more industrial farming systems towards regenerative alternatives? If we could unblock those barriers to change, it would be absolutely transformational for the history of humans. Agriculture has really been on quite the journey over the last 100 years. Before the First World War, two German scientists, Fritz Haber and Karl Bosch, were chemists working to produce bombs. And they accidentally stumbled across what we now know as the Haber-Bosch process, which is how we make nitrogen fertilizer, which has totally revolutionized the way we produce food. Where we're using high levels of inputs to produce lots of food with high environmental and health costs. For example, degrading soil health, polluting our waterways, and reducing biodiversity, just to name a few. It's also having an impact on society more generally through health. The UN has estimated that if we continue on this trajectory, we have maximum 60 harvests left, which is really scary for future generations. We are running out of time, so it's our responsibility now to do something about this. My name is Adele Jones. I'm executive director of an organisation called the Sustainable Food Trust. We are a UK-based charity working internationally to speed up the transition to regenerative agriculture. So, what is regenerative agriculture? It's really based on three core principles. Firstly, farming in harmony with nature, so food production and nature being one and indivisible rather than separate from one another. The second principle is obeying the law of return, or the circular economy as it's often referred to. So creating more closed loop farming systems where there's less inputs coming in, less waste coming out of the system, and instead you're recycling as much as possible. The third principle, and it's linked to the first two, is principle of positive health. So moving towards more biological means of producing food, less chemical inputs. Soil is, in my mind, our most valuable natural asset on planet Earth. It has huge potential to be part of the climate solution. But when you're implementing certain practices on your farm, like very deep ploughing, or worst case, using a herbicide, you're effectively creating dirt with no life in it. There are a number of practices that farmers can implement which will help the soil regenerate, help nature thrive, and help farming ultimately become part of the climate change solution. Minimum tillage or no tillage, which basically means less ploughing of the land, means that carbon can remain locked up in the soil. Rotations, where you might have only been growing two crops continuously for a number of years, where rather than relying on nitrogen fertilizer to keep giving the crop all the nutrient it needs to grow, you restore the soil naturally through a period of rest. To make money off that rest period, you could graze animals, which actually have the impact of speeding up soil fertility building anyway. Contrary to often what we hear in the media today, livestock actually have a really, really important role to play in regenerative systems. Animals speed up fertility building. So another practice is to maintain as much possible living plant material in the soil at any one time. By putting in what we call a cover crop on the winter, it means you're locking that soil in place with roots. It literally binds it in place. What challenges do we face in achieving global adoption of regenerative agriculture? So one of the most common critiques we get is that regenerative farming is not going to feed the world's rising population. At the moment, the global food system focuses around four key commodity crops that feed the majority of the population. We need to change that. We need to all start eating a much more diverse diet. The biggest barrier we face is financial. At the moment, the money is telling farmers to produce as much possible food at as low as possible cost. Don't worry about the environmental and health implications. There is such an opportunity here to shift the finances towards a truly regenerative model, where we're rewarding farmers for the positive benefits they're providing society, to the environment and public health. Things like soil health, water quality, and at the same time, providing that higher level of regulation, which starts to disincentivize the practices which are causing harm. That isn't just up to people who buy food or eat food. It's really up to the companies that control these supply chains to start sending signals to farmers, which makes them believe they can grow a greater variety of crops and have somewhere to sell them to at the end of the day. Data is going to be critical to the agricultural transition. Without data, we can't really understand where future finance should flow through to agriculture. We have been working with farmers over the last 8 years to design a framework which measures farm-level sustainability in a common way. It covers the economic, environmental, and social elements of farming. And it's really been designed in such a way which helps farmers understand the journey that they can go on, as well as companies, governments, using that data to drive finance in a new way. Collaboration around the transition to regenerative agriculture is absolutely key. Companies, governments, individuals, farmers cannot do this alone. I'm always so inspired by every farmer I meet, and for me, they're the reason why I do this. It's humbling to see how hard they work, but also how quickly they could be part of this solution. We can produce enough food for even a growing population with regenerative agriculture, but everything has to change. And I think that's the opportunity in front of us now.